Howdy y'all. So today we're going to go over how to properly saddle your horse. And today we're going to be using a Western saddle. Now there are lots of different types of Western saddles for different disciplines, depending on if you're doing reining like we're doing, or maybe you're a barrel racer, or you ride Western pleasure horses. So there's different saddles for different purposes, but how to put them all is all basically the same principles, okay? So you want to start off with a good fitting saddle pad, which is, this is the pad that I use. Just like your saddles, there's a variety of different pads that you can use. This one's kind of more contoured to the shape of my horse. Some pads are just square. You can have pads that are felt underneath, fleece underneath, or neoprene underneath. It's all totally personal preference. This is my favorite pad to use. So you'll start off by putting that on your horse. So this one's pretty easy to tell which side is the front and which side is the back, okay? Because I've got this nice cutout where her withers go, and I've got my wear leathers right here, and it's squared off in the back, okay? Sometimes you might get just a plain fleece pad that it might be a little bit more difficult to tell which side is the front and which side is the back. So always look for an area which is a little bit either more contoured or cut out in the withers, or look for these wear leathers. And those are the parts that are going to be towards the front end of the horse, okay? All right, so I got my pad on. Now I'm going to go grab my saddle. All right, so when you put on your saddle, you don't want to slap it on your horse, but you want to go ahead and lift it up real high. Make sure that you are not going to get your stirrup or your back cinch hung up. And then gently place it on their back. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do after we get our pad on and we get our saddle on their back is go ahead and add our cinch. Similar to the saddle and the pad, there's a variety of different cinches you can buy. This one is my favorite. This is the one that I use on Cholula. So you'll notice I've got this strap right here. This is called our back cinch. Not every saddle has a back cinch. It's kind of dependent on your personal preference and what discipline that you do, whether or not you're going to use one. So not every Western saddle has one, but if yours does, pay close attention. Now some people will keep their cinch attached to their saddle all the time, and if you're only riding one horse, that's probably okay to do, but it's a better practice to take your cinch off after you ride and wash it off, especially in the hot summer months. If you leave that dried on sweat on your cinch, it's going to eventually cause your horse to get a pretty bad fungus right where the cinch goes, and we don't want that to happen. So always wash your cinches. All right, so when you put your cinch on, you're going to start on the right side, get it on your off billet right here. And these rings should ideally be right in between her front legs. So I know that this is going to be right in between your front legs because this is the hole that I use on it all the time. So the next thing you're going to want to do if you have a back cinch is put your hobble strap of your back cinch onto your cinch, okay? The reason we have to have this strap is because without it, your back cinch could end up way back here on their flank, and that's how you end up with a bucking horse, okay? So always make sure that your hobble strap is securely fastened. You're just gonna fasten it to these rings down at the bottom of your cinch and buckle it and tuck that tail into the buckle. All right, we're gonna move around to the other side now. All right, I like to flip my stirrup over the top of my saddle to keep it out of the way. And then I'm going to take my latigo strap, and if you have a back cinch, you always, always, always fasten your front cinch first. Never fasten your back cinch first, okay? And I'll show you why here in just a second. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my front cinch. I'm going to go around it once with my latigo strap, back through this top ring. And then I'm going to go through one more time through the top ring and down through the cinch. legs, okay? So my Latigo straps have all these different holes in them, okay? That's to adjust the tightness. When you first saddle your horse, like when you're getting ready to ride, you don't ever want to tighten it up real tight. That's how you end up with a horse that pins their ears and grinds their teeth every time you saddle them. So you just want to kind of get it kind of loose. And then before you go to ride, then you'll tighten your cinch up and you'll know that it's tight enough because you want to be able to take like four fingers and just fit it snugly underneath that cinch. All right, so once we get our front cinch on, we can put on our back cinch. And this cinch doesn't stay as tight, okay? So we're gonna leave it just a little bit loose like this. Tuck your tail in. And that's why you don't ever wanna do your back cinch first, because we do keep the back cinch loose. So if you fasten your back cinch before you fasten your front cinch and your horse shakes, you know, shakes her body around, if this saddle, excuse me, your saddle can end up like on the belly of it, okay? We don't want that to happen. We want it to stay on the back, okay? All right, so this is where your saddle should sit on your horse's back, okay? So it's right behind the withers. You can also tell based on where your cinch is, it's right behind her elbow, okay? So we don't want the saddle to be sitting up right on top of her withers, on top of her neck, and we don't want it too far back. So this is about the right spot where your saddle should be.